My name is Dr. Joe Baldino. I have a clinic in St. Charles, Illinois, where we specialize in brain-based rehabilitation as well as neuromusculoskeletal conditions. Pretty much every patient that I see, regardless of condition that they come in stamped with or what we diagnose them as, I suggest them to use them because not only have I seen changes in them without my treatment using Voxx, but I've also seen my treatments actually supplemented by the addition of the neurotech. Typically when a client would come in or a patient comes in, I run them through my exam, which we look at equilibrium and balance and coordination and all sorts of different things. Then when it comes time for a treatment protocol, I usually apply the socks or the patch or the insoles to them and then rerun some of the objectives tests or just my bedside tests as well to see if it's gonna be a good fit or it's gonna help kind of amplify the treatment I'm already thinking of prescribing. As far as results go, I've seen everything from sort of trivial results to what things that look like miracles, especially in brain-based rehabilitation like concussion, vertigo and migraines, and even movement disorders we've seen improvement in. The other thing that I look highly at is eye movement. So the ability for somebody to track an object or even get to a target and stay on a target, those are very, very indicative of different parts of the brain working or not working. What I've noticed with applying the tech to those conditions is we see immediate results almost within a 5 to 8 minute time frame where it's noticeably and measurably different. And then the longer we have them on the tech, and then I apply some of the traditional treatment methods like eye exercises or balance exercises, then we actually can retest and we'll see significant jumps. I made Voxx Life products a standard of care in the clinic for every patient, every new patient that comes in, and even the existing patients. I recommend and I show them, I put them through their balance tests and stability stuff, only because I've seen it enhance any treatment I've ever been capable of doing for them. So when patients put the socks on during the exam and then we reapply, retest them for their balance or coordination, they have a visible reaction to them. Like they're always surprised at how they feel once we rerun those tests. And they're always surprised when we can literally say, oh, look, we measured these numbers and they're a bit better. There are folks who have come in who can't perceive as well. Like they just don't perceive their body. But that's why we use the objective findings to show them, look, you did improve. I would highly recommend Voxx Life in any implement way to any practitioner, whether it be medical or naturopathic or chiropractic or physical therapy. Any manual practitioner, without a doubt, should be implementing these things. I know it's hard to understand the concept of how it works because it's so not clinical, like neurology, but what it does to the effect, to affect the neurology of somebody, just enhance treatments, and then it just helps people's quality of life. Implementing Voxx Life into my clinic, I thought was gonna be a daunting task. I'm not a clinic that sells supplements. I really don't have anything of a retail. It's just me as a service. So I've always been off put by a product. But when I saw how easy it was for me to just show the patient, here's this product, it really does do what it says it does, it became so much more easy to just recommend it. And dealing with getting the inventory, getting it set up, even coaching me on how to set things up, a display, because that was all foreign to me. I had no clue how to use this stuff. And yeah, the team, the back office team up there, they gave me so much valuable advice that I was able to just easily have some stock here, and as well as direct patients, you know, where it just became part of the conversation now. We had this young kid, 17-year-old kid. It was one of the first times I ever used Voxx by itself without me intervening in the beginning. He had a concussion so bad that an artery ruptured inside his brain, and then the blood started to accumulate in the skull and started crushing on the brain, to the point where he got into the car with his family after this hockey game, and he looked around the car and he's like, you all look like really nice people, but can you take me back to my family? And so he couldn't recognize anybody in the car, his mom, his dad, he's got the brother and sister. So they immediately bring him to the ER. He gets this decompression surgery, and essentially he's just left you know, to just heal. And a few months go by after he's healed, but he has almost none of the same personality anymore, no traits. He can't pay attention in school. He was this Division I athlete on track for go to a law school is what his aspiration was. And when I met him, he had gotten kicked out of school because he then started fights, like his whole personality and demeanor changed. And when he came in to see me, I run a lot of tests where I look at eye movements and balance. And this is a Division I athlete, like he should have impeccable athleticism, and he almost had none of it. And there's a test I run that looks at the speed of eye movements. And when I ran this test on him, you're supposed to pick up a certain amount of eye movements, and he literally, the machine only picked up 1 out of 100. And it was just profound. Like he doesn't even have the tools to generate a movement of his eye. So it's like, I was really hopeless that I could do anything for him. But something just gave me a nudge to say, hey, try these socks on him. And so all I did was I ran this eye test, didn't get very good results at all, put the socks on him and left him for about 5 minutes till it took me to reset this eye test, and then re-ran the test. And the most profound thing was all of the eye movements, like 50 in each direction, came back. And it was like mind blowing to the point, like, you know, me and the parents were like high-fiving each other, because it was like it just woke up the area I needed to use to help rehab him. So it was like it wasn't there beforehand. And in my training, if it's not there, I can't use it. Since I've started adding Voxx to the patient protocols, I've been getting such profound feedback that people noticeably can feel a difference if they miss a day wearing their socks or not. And somebody described it like wearing glasses. It's like you wear glasses for better vision. When you don't have them, you have poor vision. Same sort of thing.